Welcome, guys, to the Pretty Bad Gamers. I'm George.
Harry.
This is Harry, and that's Percy.
Hi.
And today we're going to talk about the Xbox conference. This week is E3 week, so we're going to talk about the game, give you our thoughts, and what we thought of the conference overall. So, so let's get into it. The conference started with the new game, Obsidian Outer Worlds. You play a stranger, you get to make good, evil choices or psychotic choices, is what they told us about it. Kind of the makers of Fallout New Vegas. And kind of, you can almost say it's kind of a spiritual successor. So what did you guys think?
Percy.
Hey.
It was I think it's a little bit hard to judge right now for me.
Yeah.
Because the footage was not that long, you know, and what I saw was like, I got questions basically, yeah. You know. So I want to see a little bit more before I can really judge to buy it or not. But like the Las Vegas or Fallout was the best.
But did you like the? Do you like the Fallout games? Do you like that kind of style?
Yeah. That's why. And what I saw, you know, you can make like the choices, like you said, and stuff. That is, that's always what I like. Yeah. You know. So you know, you got the choices and, yeah.
Yeah.
Question marks.
You, Percy, Fallout something you like and it's this kind of game Outer Worlds?
Well, the problem I always had with Fallout was that I didn't like the world because it all looked like shit and crap everywhere.
Yeah,
and
gray
it's like.
Everywhere.
Yeah, gray and brown and poop. Everywhere is poop. And I thought, no, I don't like go into a fantasy world that's like more shitty than the real world. I want to go into a world that's like more positive, more colors. And that's what I think why the Outer Rim would be better, because it's more of a functioning world, but still with the Fallout concept of the diverging quest, I believe,
yeah.
I hope.
Yeah, and that's kind of the thing. That's what I thought about. It's a more lively place, more atmosphere, like the colors. That's something you already mentioned, something that isn't right there. And I think it's one to look forward to, but like Harry already said, it was not a lot of gameplay or something. I'd like to say like a half hour playthrough, you know, to see what the game really is.
Okay, yeah.
But of course, Ninja Theory come to the stage, Xbox bought them last year, and basically they said, we're making a game, it's called Bleeding Edge, and that's it. It's going to be a combat action game, 4v4, but didn't show really anything of it, so yeah, no sense in talking about it. Then Ori, a new Ori game is coming out February 11th,
awesome.
2020.
Yes, I like Oreos. I like to twist them and then lick one part off.
Well, they're actually out right now.
Oh.
Those Oreos. This is the new Wisp thingy side scroller.
I didn't play the Ori and the Blood and the Forest something. I didn't play that one because I don't have an Xbox.
Oh yeah, it's an Xbox exclusive.
It's an Xbox exclusive.
That's a good one.
But I'm happy that the Xbox people get another game because I heard it was very well received by the public, and I'm happy for them that they have this new
something
game
new
to look forward.
We'll keep playing God of War or something like that.
Yeah, Spider-Man,
Last of Us 2.
You got an Xbox, man.
Yeah, I got an Xbox, but it's not really my type of game. I'm not really into the side scrollers
anymore.
It's kind of, I like the bigger games, it's just not my type of game. Then we got Minecraft Dungeons.
Yes.
This spring, 4-player co-op and an adventure game.
Shit, we're missing one.
We're missing one. If Wim was here, we could have played before.
It's been a while.
But personally, not looking for it. Not really.
Have you ever played a dungeon crawler or?
I played Dot Hack, and that's kind of dungeon crawler.
Ask.
Ask, yeah. Ask, yeah. But it's not, yeah, it's not really... I just don't like the aesthetics of Minecraft.
Oh, okay.
It's simple. It doesn't do anything for me. Yeah. I like the things people create, like Game of Thrones, King's Landing, they made out of Minecraft. Oh, man, that's cool. But not like, oh, I'm going to play that.
It's really,
yeah. Making things nice to look at. And now, do you like Minecraft? Are you...
Nah, sometimes I watch in SharePlay with a friend of mine, but it's a pixel game, you know. So.
Yeah, so you just like to watch pixel games.
Nah, it's more that you have fun in the party and shit. And yeah.
You have to waste some time.
Yeah, and I make jokes about him playing it, you know. So that's why. You know.
Yeah.
Yeah, and Percy.
Yeah, I played a little Minecraft. Was fun to play, but. It's a real time sink, and if you want to build something very creative, it takes a lot of time. But if you have the dedication, then yes. But this is, no. This is, I think, this is for fans of Minecraft that also are fans of dungeon crawlers, and now they have like their perfect game for them.
Yeah, something to play. Yeah. And you could play Minecraft with Facebook as a things, right?
I don't know.
Or maybe this game. But then, my notes say, Phil Spencer gives a speech. He talks about what's to come for the show. Not really something to... Then Star Wars Fallen Jedi. So tell me about it. Star Wars Fallen Jedi. Have you seen the trailers?
Yeah, I saw them. And the graphics look really good. But... Yeah, like I said earlier, I'm not really a Star Wars fanboy. Really so
they also gave a demo at E3 or for the EA press thingy they did.
Yeah,
and they showed off a demo with a little bit of gameplay. I thought it looked okay, but not really. It doesn't look like a bad game, but it also doesn't look like a real good game or anything like that. Have you seen anything about Star Wars?
It looks very basic, I would say. You know, it's like basic EA. Yeah, we know you can make pretty games. You know, you can make them look good, but the gameplay didn't look so exciting. The level traversal didn't like that either. It was like Prince of Persia like.
Yeah.
And I was like, okay, well, that's... Yeah, no, that's not what I expect from a Jedi game, you know? You want more combat-heavy and just conversational.
Yeah, you want to focus on the story.
Yeah, right? If you're, like, climbing buildings, then what am I doing in this Star Wars? Maybe it's cool. Yeah,
well, it's something they're really pushing. It's like... It's going to be a story, it's going to be in the canon of the Star Wars cinematic universe thing. The thing is, they always said that there won't be any choice between light and dark side, so they do have a story they want to tell. And I think I was expecting something like an Uncharted game, more like, okay, you're going to tell your story, make it... really cinematic, and you have Star Wars, so
yeah,
it shouldn't be that hard. And maybe it's just early in the game and they didn't show off the right part of it where it gets exciting, but I think it didn't have a good showing. The one thing I would say, a lot of press that went behind the scenes and had a demo, they already got said it was were really positive about it, and they showed off something a little further ahead in the game, and it had a little more action and more it looked a little bit better, but yeah, it's another good game I'm gonna buy day one, and probably when it's like $10, $20. I will waste an afternoon.
Yeah, that, PlayStation Plus.
Yeah, PlayStation Plus. Yeah. Do it for us.
Yeah.
Blair, and then next they came with the Blair Witch. Of course, based on the inspired by the movie, it's gonna be some freaky horror story thing. It looked okay.
Cool.
Yeah. Nothing really special.
I don't think.
But is it something you're gonna play?
PlayStation Plus.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
I'm not buying that one.
I'm probably not even playing it if it's free, man.
I'll at least add it to my library.
Yeah, exactly. That's what I'm going to do.
One day.
Yeah. Maybe for a visitor.
Yeah, but then for I think the biggest thing in the conference happened. Cyberpunk 2077.
Oh, yeah.
We got a trailer. It showed Keanu Reeves got on stage. Told that everybody was, what was it, breathtaking.
Yeah.
By the way, funny fact, the guy who said, oh, you're breathtaking, they're giving him a free collector's edition of Cyberpunk 2077.
Really? Yeah. Shit. I think you're breathtaking too, man.
So, let's start off with Percy. Cyberpunk 2077. Tell us your thoughts.
My thoughts.
Did it get you hyped?
It did give me a little hyped. I was like, okay, I'm definitely buying this, but also because it's CD Projekt Red. And I can't, I can't not buy their games on the first day because they're one of the best companies out there. The most, thinking of the players and of the of their clients.
The people that buy their games.
Yeah, they see most as people, not as like just wallets that need to pay more for games. Infinitely keep paying for playing this game.
And yeah, especially after what I've done with The Witcher, the DLCs and everything like that. It's like, I'm in the same boat. Like, I already pre-ordered my collector's edition. I'm like, okay, I'm in, take my money. You have my money now and I'll just wait.
Take my money now.
Yeah, they said the release date was...
2020?
April 16th. Do you think they're going to hit that release date?
I think they're gonna get the year 2020 because the original was based Cyberpunk 2020 was the
board game.
It's a Dungeons and Dragons kind of game. I don't know how we don't play it a lot in Holland. I think.
At least we didn't.
And we didn't know. It's a pen and paper RPG, I believe.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. So I'm excited.
Harry, did you join the hype wagon?
Hype! Come on, Harry!
Yeah. I gotta say, man, George, man, you were right, man. You know, we did the preview, you know, from the A3 conference, and you said pre-order it, you know. And I was like, maybe. But, you know, then again, you know, you saw Mr. Reeves, you know, and it was basically done, man.
No.
But I definitely like the trailer, though. You know, I'm not into the type of with like very advanced technology and that kind of stuff. I don't like that stuff. Yeah, that's what I don't like actually.
Yeah.
But I think I should give this game a chance, man.
Yeah, seriously, I think you should, give it a chance.
Yeah.
It's I'm thinking the same thing too, or because I played Deus Ex, Mankind Revolution, I think. Yeah. And I like the game, but just the setting, the cyberpunk, does not. Intrigue me so much, but just because it's CD Projekt Red and I trust that they'll make a very intriguing world that draws game, you in.
Yeah, and I think with Deus Ex is extremely dark, the things I've seen, and the things I like about the setting is that you see a lot of neon colors and it's a little bit colorful, and like you said, I'm more of a fantasy kind of guy, but CD Projekt Red, man, you just have to, man.
I said I was gonna buy it when the price was right, you know, but I'm probably gonna pre-order it now.
Is right when
exactly, so, you know.
So, okay.
Take a sip of water.
Okay, moving on.
Yes.
Spirit Force.
Who?
Yeah. I don't even remember that game, man. Seriously. I already forgot it.
Not Mother of Impression.
Bad Impression, yeah.
But after that, there came Battletoads. So, and Battletoads, one of the games I played when I was young and never got past the third level or fourth level where you have to race.
Yeah.
But three-player co-op. And it looks like a beat-em-up game. So are you guys a little bit excited, Harry?
No.
Battletoads?
No.
not excited, but like, I'll play it.
Does it look like fun to you?
No, not really.
No?
Not even a little. Did you play the original Battletoads?
No.
Okay.
No, so.
Percy.
Yeah.
So. Sorry.
It was a I believe in it. I can believe it can be fun again. Maybe they fixed that level 3 that you can actually pass it a little easier. That would be nice.
Well, what I understand is it's a new game. I could be wrong about it.
Oh, maybe
this,
it wasn't. Huh? Oh, okay. I didn't know. So,
but it looked. Yeah. They changed the whole art style. They remade it. So.
Yeah.
It should be passable. Still hard, I think. But.
Yeah.
And the thing I like, it's like co-op and. That's the kind of game I would like to play co-op with you guys. And
yeah, sometimes.
Just try when it's hard. Record some of it and.
Have fun.
Have fun. And
okay.
But we'll switch around with women and
yeah, exactly. Okay, deal, man. Deal. I'll take that, man.
Then a woman gives a speech, comes on the Xbox stage, talks about Xbox Game Pass, Xbox Game Pass coming for the PC.
Okay.
You'll be able to play Xbox games on the PC. And they got a new...
Okay, so why am I buying Xboxes now?
Yeah, that's kind of the question. It's kind of feels like you're giving up.
Yeah. Ah, fuck consoles. Well,
it's cheaper than a PC.
Yeah, it is cheaper, but...
Yeah, you can do way more with a PC, like edit videos and, download torrents. We don't download torrents here, that's very...
No, we illegal. Never.
No. You know, watch YouTube.
Okay, are you going?
Those kind of thing.
Yeah. They also talked about Xbox Game Pass Ultimate. That includes Xbox Live Gold, Xbox Game Pass, and the Game Pass for the PC. Because it's not one Game Pass. You have the Game Pass for your Xbox and then Game Pass subscription for your PC.
Oh, okay.
And then they bundle that all together. They didn't give a price, surprisingly.
Okay. Well.
So... it's okay, I guess.
Sure.
I mean, I do like the Game Pass because you get the games day one, the exclusive Xbox games day one. So I kind of see the value in it, but I don't know yet. I'm like wait and see. It's all depending on the price right now.
Okay.
And but for the PC today, it's $1. Which you guys have nothing, you have no use for this information because it will be passed by the time
this
is aired.
Oh.
Then we got Flight Simulator, so it's a game with airplanes and you can fly. That's
looks good.
It looks good. It is what it's Flight Simulator.
I think some pilots will be happy if they have the whole setup. Yeah. And then they can get some flying hours in.
Yeah, but I don't know if Xbox has that.
Well, they're better. I hope so. Well,
but Xbox for PC.
Exactly. You can just play it in the PC and then you can log some more flight hours for the pilots. That's good.
So, okay. Then Age of Empires 2 Ultimate Edition. I'll just let Harry talk then. Huh?
Yeah. So, cool. I was pretty hyped though. But, nah.
Nah?
No, I'm a big fan of Age of Empires 2, but... to me, you know, it's like a remake, so we already had like better graphics, but they're gonna upgrade it now a little bit more, I guess. And there's coming a DLC, but for me, it's just a remaster of a remaster with some DLC content.
What I understand,
you know,
from it is they're gonna remake the whole game, really.
Yeah, but new sound and okay, that is kind of cool, you know. They're gonna add a new sound to the game and. But I'm really like, you know, for me it's more like a DLC with a remastered, you know, so.
You're not interested in playing it at all? I mean, you're the Age of Empires.
Age
of Empires.
Yeah, exactly. But that was because I was pretty fucking hyped for Age of Empires 4, you know? This is a bit of a letdown. Like I said, it's a remaster of a remaster with DLC content. Four extra civilizations, though. That is pretty cool.
Yeah, but is then more that the rumors ruined it for you? Because the rumors were that Age of Empires 4 was coming. And then you get Age of Empires 3 remake, so... It's kind of
but we already got a HD version, you know, and I'm like, you know, this is not really gonna add something extra though, so a bit of a bummer.
And Percy, how are you in with Age of Empires? Did you ever play it?
I did play it. Like playing it. One thing I always hated was that as soon as battles start, then like all tactics go out the window. Yeah. Because, okay, everyone's lined up and the archers are in the back. And then battle starts and everyone's just in a big crowd around one guy. Because I told him to attack this one guy. I mean, attack in everyone that's coming at you. No, don't break formation just because I told you to attack someone. But we played it a lot in the past, Age of Mythology, mostly.
Age of Mythology, yeah.
And it was fun, you know, it was fun to play with each other, of course. Playing with friends always makes the game good.
And that's what Age of Mythology is, one of the games that, even though I always lost, I still like the game.
Mm-hmm.
And that rarely happens for me, because I'm quite competitive. So, I hope for Age of Mythology 2 still. Come on, guys, let's do this. I mean, we didn't get Age of Empires 4. We can live without that, but we need Age of Mythology 2.
Fuck you, man.
So, then after Age of Empires, I lost my Wasteland 3. Matt Booty, head of studios, came up, and I made a small mistake.
Yeah, these.
Wasteland 3, it's a game.
Yeah.
It was on the Xbox conference. Forgive me. Let's move on.
Okay.
So Matt Booty came on, head of studios, and announced they acquired Double Fine. Announced the game Psychonauts 2.
Oh.
Showed off a little trailer. It was okay. It wasn't anything really special. Did any of you guys play Psychonauts?
One? No. Hearsay, I heard that it's like a little bit of a cult classic, and it has a very good sense of humor, very funny game, I hear. I did play the VR game into the Rompus of, oh, it's a hard name, forget it, VR, Psychonauts, Double Fine also, and there's just a lot of humor, a lot of style in that game, and people have been waiting for sequel, so
okay.
Again,
here it is. So, here it comes.
Little style, little humor is something Xbox could use. Yeah. They don't have that in their library. It's mostly serious and action. We have Fable, but you didn't show anything of Fable, so we have to wait till next year.
Next year
is the E3 of Dreams.
Okay.
And all the games that I want are gonna be there.
Cool.
We're gonna have the Xbox 5. We got off the PlayStation 5 and the Xbox 2. And life is gonna be
2. Good.
Yes.
It's a strange counting way. From Xbox 360.
Yeah, it's gonna be
from one, Xbox 2.
Yeah.
It's gonna be called Xbox 2.
No, I don't know, but we're
going.
Okay, and we're back. And moving on. After Psychonauts, Dragon Ball Z Project. They gave it a name, Dragon Ball Z Kakarot. It's an action RPG, it's coming early 2020. You're gonna play the story of Dragon Ball Z as Kakarot.
Again. Yeah.
And but they made it's an RPG and are you into Dragon Ball Z?
It looked very cool, but I've seen it before. I've seen it too many times now. It's the same story over and over, but okay, you know, another one. Let's play it. Let's get into it.
This is the weird thing with Dragon Ball games at me. So I always buy them at the discount, you know, when they're... And I always have fun with them.
Mm-hmm.
With the Xenoverse game is Dragon Ball Z Fighters. They're all really fun games to play, just not, for me, worth the full price.
Yeah.
And this kind of looks the same, like you already said, we already seen this story. We don't know how far it's going to reach. Is it going to go all the way to the Buu Saga? Is it going to go all the way into Dragon Ball Super?
It should.
To Dragon Ball Broly. It should, right?
Yeah, it should. Like,
if you're going to start that, at least you've got to end it all the way at Dragon Ball Super. Otherwise, you're just repeating the same thing. And it's Dragon Ball Z Kakarot, and... And it's kind of a bum that I won't get to play as Goku then, because I would much rather have chosen my own Dragon Ball fighter and then left him. Like, if I wanted to be Krillin, you know, I'm going as Krillin.
Yeah.
And then Krillin beats Frieza or something.
That would be fun
to play for. I would like that. But maybe something like that will be in the game. They didn't show a lot, only a trailer. So,
Yeah, but last year we also got like a Dragon Ball Z game, right? The Fighter was...
Fighter Z is fair. Where was that last year?
Or this year?
No, it wasn't this year. I think it was... No, there was Dragon Ball Z Fighters. That was your last year. And there was another game with Goku, Vegeta... and then Yu-Gi-Oh! Was in there for some reason, and
that was with everyone.
Yeah, with all the Jump characters.
Jump, Shonen Jump.
Shonen Jump, something.
Yeah.
So, I will play it eventually, I'm sure of it.
One day we'll see it on the channel.
Yeah, one day we'll see it on the channel. Not when it's released. Probably a year later, but...
Yeah.
Or never, who knows?
No.
Really?
He'll buy it one time.
I'll buy the Dragon Ball Z game. It's, like I said, when it's discounted 10, 20 euros, you know, I'm in for it.
I got no connection whatsoever with Dragon Ball Z.
No, you never watched it as a kid?
No. Yeah, no, I didn't like it, you know?
You didn't like the Piccolo Gohan when he ran for him?
No, I saw one movie, you know, in the theater, but that was because I had to, you know. I made a deal with a friend of mine, you know.
That shouldn't be your introduction.
Yeah, no, that's the worst way you can see it.
Yeah, okay. No, they but you had, like, on telly, you had, like, the cartoon version.
Yeah.
You know, I saw that a little bit too, but it didn't get me, you know, so.
Okay.
No, yeah. No hero's journey for you.
Nope.
Then we got 12 Minutes. 12 Minutes, it's an murder mystery game. It's kind of got a top-down perspective.
Yeah.
And a guy gets killed a guy with his wife gets killed every 12 minutes. No, the guy gets killed and then he jumps back in time just like a Groundhog Day.
Mm-hmm.
And he starts just 12 minutes over and he has to solve the mystery and try to stop the murder.
Okay.
And the trailer was really intense, really got me hooked, so I'm really looking forward to it. Percy, what did you see of 12 Minutes?
I saw a little bit of it. I didn't get the 12 minutes reference, so it's like you jump back and then you make different choices and then maybe different outcomes.
And it's only 12 minutes, so it's really short.
It's 12 minutes and you keep playing the same 12 minutes.
I think it's a really small game, like you play 2-3 hours of the game, you probably finish the game.
Then it's interesting for a small little at the side game.
Yeah, that's it, at the side.
Yeah, saw it and got me thinking a little bit about the Netflix series. I don't know what the name was again, but it was with Natasha Lyonne. But, you know, I don't like the top view, you know.
Yeah.
That's something maybe you like. But
no, it's not really it really looks different. And that's kind of the thing I like about it. It looks different. It got, for me, it engaged me in the story. You know, I wanted to know, how do you get out of this? And
but are you going
to
buy it?
Eventually, I'll probably buy it.
Yeah? For the right price.
For the right price.
For the right price.
But, even kijken. yeah, let's see. giving you some Dutch lessons while we edit.
Yeah.
So, Way to the World. We're gonna skip right over that. And then we had Gears of War 5. Bound by Blood. And one of the games I really look forward to. It focuses on a new protagonist, the girl from 4, I lost her name right now, but it's coming out September 10th. They showed off a new game mode, Escape. Escape is a game mode you can 3-player co-op. And actually, I was a little surprised that they didn't show more of the game. It's coming out September 10th. They didn't really show anything of the campaign or anything like that. So, you guys played Gears of War, Harry?
Yeah, with you only a little bit.
So, yeah.
So, like I did play it, but you know how I think about Gears of War, man.
Yeah, you don't play shit.
Damn.
I played Gears of War 1, 2, and then I lost it at, I think I played Judgment with you.
Oh yeah, we played Judgment together.
Yeah. I didn't like Judgment at all, actually. It was very, let's just get to this. And then I didn't play 3 and I didn't play 4.
Yeah.
So I'm kind of off the Gears train since 2. and I haven't really been into it.
But did you like the multiplayer of it, you guys? The multiplayer?
Multiplayer.
Was that kind of the strong part of the whole game, like the story aside? It's okay.
Well, the story was fun to do, to play together and just have to...
That's the co-op was fun in it. And,
exactly.
But,
and then, of course, the online playing 4v4 and then having an instant death always that you... You have one life, so better be careful. Don't just rush in and go for it. But it was, it was very enjoyable always, the multiplayer. But now you have so much multiplayer that it's not...
Yeah, so many games.
In so many games, and most games now are only multiplayer. So it's like, okay, you know, it's not special anymore.
Yeah, you only have time for so much games.
Exactly.
But yeah, and I hope they really bring back, since you didn't play 4, like... After that, they had a new game mode, Deathmatch, and you just respawned and you had 50 lives, so just went down and the team with no lives at the end, of course, wins.
Yeah.
And that really took kind of the joy away from Gears 4 for me, because what you said, be careful with your life, you know, you don't just rush in. You kind of lost that to me, but apparently most players liked it because they still had execution, but matchmaking, you wouldn't fight anything. So, and the one thing is, they didn't show a lot of the story, so my hope is they're holding back because they think they got something special there, so they don't want to spoil anything.
Yeah.
So I'm really optimistic, and you know, September 10th is coming, so they got my money.
Okay, good.
That's one thing is for sure, so better prepared to play it with me.
Okay.
Is it on Xbox One or Xbox...
It's on Xbox One.
Xbox One still.
Yes.
Yeah. Because what did we play, George?
We played Horde mode.
That was decent. That was decent, but you know.
Enjoyable.
It's fun to do with your friends, basically. But yeah, you know, that's it. So.
But then we got a new Elite controller.
Cool.
€180.
Oh, not so cool. Oh, you can buy a VR headset for that when it's on sale.
Almost.
So you can have four VR headset or a Pro controller.
Yeah.
For the Xbox, you don't have. See?
Oh, and then you have to buy an Xbox, of course.
Well, when I looked at it, it looked really cool. You could put the sensitivity of your analog sticks, It all looked cool, but I'm not paying €180.
Yeah.
Just not happy. Then we got Dying Light 2, a zombie game.
Cool.
Let's just move on.
And
then everything was awesome in Forza 4 with the Lego expansion.
Yeah.
They have a new world. You can get to play with Lego cars in a Lego world, drive around, race.
You can make your own tracks also, or...
They didn't say that.
Probably not then.
Probably not.
Yeah. Lego, you can build everything. So you can build the cars and then you can build the track and then...
Yeah, no, that would be nice, but they're not going to do that. That's a lot more work. And who wants to build with Lego blocks?
Yeah.
Then we got Gears Pop. I'm not even going to talk about that. A State of Decay 2 expansion. Awesome. Story mode. Cool. Final Fantasy Online RPG.
Star Citizen? I don't remember. Not Star Citizen. I'm sorry. Fantasy Star Online 2. Or was that another? I don't know. I saw too much.
Either one of those. Then Tales of Asperia coming 2020. Borderlands coming September 13th, 2019. And we don't need to talk about Borderlands or any of you.
You like Borderlands?
No.
No.
I like Borderlands.
Harry doesn't like shit.
I don't play shit.
No, that's not true. It's not that I don't play shit, you know. Because I tried The Witcher, right?
Oh, yeah.
Stay tuned.
So, yeah.
Oh, yeah, exactly.
Games Harry doesn't like. But have to play.
Yes.
Harry does like shit.
Yeah.
But then we got Elden Ring. We got a cinematic trailer. This is a game from Software. apparently George R. R. Martin is helping co-create this. And it was a cool trailer, but didn't show really anything.
Yeah.
There was.
What was it? Game of Thrones or something else?
Eldering.
Eldering
is a game in George R. R. Martin, of course, written.
Okay.
Game of Thrones books.
Okay.
So.
I don't know if that would translate to video games.
Yeah, I don't know either. The trailer looked cool, but nothing really of interest, actually.
Yeah.
Why does my nose keep doing this?
Yeah.
Okay, so after that, Phil Spencer comes to the stage, talks about xCloud. It's a streaming service so that you don't need a console anymore. You can play anywhere. All you need is a controller. What do you guys think? xCloud, playing games without an Xbox.
Yeah.
Don't care.
Don't care. But you guys don't have Xboxes.
So I don't have Xbox. Yeah.
Would you consider getting a subscription for a month, like if the new Halo or Gears or a game you like comes out,
and
then name a game I like then.
Yeah.
Okay. Percy, you like to play games.
Yeah. It depends on how much it would be.
Yeah.
The subscription.
They didn't give a price yet.
No. Okay. And then probably, yeah, sure. If you like said, oh, come on, let's play Gears together, then yeah, sure, I'll come play Gears with you.
Yeah.
But other than that, not for myself.
I think it's kind of weird that they're coming out with this surf because you don't really need the Xbox anymore.
So yeah.
Are they kind of looking this as a future investment so that the Xbox will eventually just disappear and we'll all be on the cloud?
Yeah, I think they're just diversifying, so they have so some people buy this and some people buy this and some people buy this, and then they have their
spreading the market.
Their product, so people have all the options they want to play the games they want in the way they want it. That's real player choice, actually.
Yeah, that's actually true. And I would be nice to see what next gen coming, could they handle that, or can they only handle Xbox One games? Or
because
it's a lot of data, especially when you're going 4K, 8K.
Yep.
That we in the Netherlands have good internet, but
yeah, even rest for of the us, world.
It's gonna be a tough thing.
Yeah.
And then Phil Spencer kept on talking and talking and talking. And then he said, let's talk about the next console. Project Scarlet. It's coming holiday 2020. They say it's 4 times more powerful than the Xbox X, so the latest Xbox. They were really talking about the loading times being a lot faster. Almost faster. No loading times, okay. A lot faster. They talked about the SSD storage, which allows it to load a lot faster.
Yes.
Project Scarlet. Are you guys excited about next gen?
Yeah, for PlayStation, man, but not for Xbox. Sorry, man. I don't have anything with Xbox, you know.
No, but it's an indication for the PlayStation 5, because PlayStation 5 won't lag behind.
Yeah.
It will either come sooner or at date, just like the Xbox.
Yeah, but like you said earlier, you know, why do you still need an Xbox if you can just, you know, if you have a controller and you get that, what was the service called again?
xCloud?
Yeah, and then you can play, you know, so.
Yeah.
What's the point?
So basically,
consumer choice, like Percy said.
Yeah,
but now I understand the controller, man. The 180 euros controller.
Yeah, I don't think that's the controller that people with xCloud was going to use, because I think if you use xCloud, you're more of a casual gamer.
Yeah.
You don't.
The really good thing is actually when you go to friends and they don't have Xbox, you don't have to bring your Xbox. You just say, you know, I'll take a subscription for that shit for a month or so.
And then
you're going to play over there, yeah.
Yeah, when you got friends over.
Yeah, exactly.
Party,
But no, not really hyped for the new Xbox. But what about you, man? I mean, you're the Xbox guy, man. Are you going to buy one?
I'm going to buy one.
Pre-order?
Day one. Because, the one thing is the new Halo, I'm kind of it's been a long time, and they announced that Halo will be the launch title of the Project Scarlet.
Yeah.
And with the studios they acquired, I'm kind of like, okay, you got my trust again. You seem to have learned from your mistakes. The rumors of a new Fable. I mean, come on, Fable for me. I just need to play that. It's reason enough.
Reason enough, basically.
And so it's gonna be an expensive next year for me. They showed off Halo. Showed off a little trailer. Didn't show a lot.
No, well, nothing at all.
Yeah, I think they showed. Maybe that was the opening we saw. I'm asking this, but how do you guys think? What do you think about Halo? Harry, give yourself think about Halo. Please.
I never played it, so you know it's really hard to say, man. It's okay. One of the things I didn't play, but if you're gonna buy that Xbox, you know, I will give it a go. I mean, like, the graphics looked pretty good, you know, when I saw the Halo, the cinematics, you know, but it was really cool with the, what was it called, the chief, you know, in that suit, you know, and he was like, you know, in the beginning not really answering the guy. I don't know, man.
It's like, Master Chief.
It's Master Chief. Shit, man. Damn. I didn't know. But, you know, I'm about to find out when you buy the Xbox. You know, I'll check it out and we'll see, man.
Yeah. Do you know who Mario is?
Who's that, man?
And the plumber.
Yeah.
And that was it, guys. That was the conference. So, what did you guys think of the conference overall, and what was your number one game you were hyped for and you want to pre-order now?
I think we all have the same, man.
Cyberpunk!
Exactly. So, you know, that is going to be a thing, man.
Yeah, that's... Yeah.
Even I'm going to play it, you know? I mean, like, fuck.
if you are going to play it, are you going to finish it?
Finish is always hard. Maybe I even won't finish it. Maybe.
Yeah, you will finish it.
Probably.
Yeah, we will look at it.
I will try it. I said I'm going to pre-order it, you know? Yeah, okay, that is a big step for me for a game like that. So, you know, have some faith, man.
Worth your money. Mm-hmm.
You said that, you know, and for what I saw right now, I gave you right. So, you know, that was already hard for me to commit. So, you know. So.
Well, you're growing.
Your
place.
Mm-hmm.
Crazy motherfucker.
Kind of the weird thing, by the way, is that the game we're most excited for isn't an Xbox game.
Yeah. At
the Xbox conference is kind of, good luck. So, do you guys have any last words over the Xbox conference? And
I like that they showed a lot of games. I like that there wasn't too much business talk. And everything was... going very
flow to it.
Games, little bit of talking, not too much, so it's fine.
Let's do it.
It's good.
Okay, and so with that, we're gonna close it out for the day. I'm George, that's Harry, and that's Percy. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Sure. See you guys next time.
Okay.
Bye.
You're breathtaking. You're all breathtaking.